ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। Today we are discussing chapter 10, text number 9 of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. I will read the text and you all can repeat after me. Machitta Madgata Prana Bodhayanta Parasparam Khatayan Tishyamam Nityam Tushyanti Cha Ramanti Cha. Word to word meaning, translation and purport by Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Machitta, their minds fully engaged in me. Madgata prana, their lives devoted to me. Bodhayantaha, preaching. Parasparam, among themselves. Kadayantaha, talking. Cha, also, mom, about me, nityam, perpetually, tushyanti, become pleased, cha, also, ramanti, enjoy transcendental bliss, cha, also. The thoughts of my pure devotees dwell in me. Their lives are fully devoted to my service and they derive great satisfaction and bliss from always enlightening one another and conversing about me. You all can kindly repeat after me. The thoughts of my pure devotees dwell in me. Their lives are fully devoted to my service. And they derive great satisfaction and bliss from always enlightening one another and conversing about me. Purport. Pure devotees whose characteristics are mentioned here engage themselves fully in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. Their moods can't be diverted from the lotus feet of Krishna. Their talks are solely on the transcendental subjects. The symptoms of pure devotees are described in this verse specifically. Devotees of the Supreme Lord are 24 hours daily engaged in glorifying the qualities and pastimes of the Supreme Lord. Their hearts and souls are constantly submerged in Krishna. And they take pleasure in discussing Him with other devotees. They take pleasure in discussing Him with other devotees. In the preliminary stage of devotional service, they relish the transcendental pleasure from the service itself. And in the mature stage, they are actually situated in love of God. Once situated in the transcendental position, they can relish the highest perfection which is exhibited by the Lord in His abode. Lord Chaitanya likens transcendental devotional service to the sowing of a seed in the heart of the living entity. There are innumerable living entities traveling throughout the different planets of the universe, and out of them there are a few who are fortunate enough to meet a pure devotee and get the chance to understand devotional service. This devotional service is like a seed, and if it is sown in the heart of a living entity, and if he goes on hearing and chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, that seed fructifies just as the seed of a tree fructifies with regular watering. The spiritual plant of devotional service gradually grows and grows until it penetrates the covering of the material universe and enters into Brahma Jyoti effulgence in the spiritual sky. In the spiritual sky also, that plant grows more and more until it reaches the highest planet, which is called Goloka Vrindavana, the supreme planet of Krishna. Ultimately, the plant takes shelter under the lotus feet of Krishna and rests there. Gradually, as a plant grows fruits and flowers, that plant of devotional service also produces fruits, and the watering process in the form of chanting and hearing goes on. This plant of devotional service is fully described in Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela chapter 19. It is explained that when the complete plant takes shelter under the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, one becomes fully absorbed in love of God. Then he cannot live even for a moment without being in contact with the Supreme Lord, just as a fish cannot live without water. In such a state, the devotee actually attains the transcendental qualities in contact with the Supreme Lord. The Supreme Bhagavan, in Srimad Bhagavatam, it is also full of such narrations about the relationship between the Supreme Lord and His devotees. Therefore, the Srimad Bhagavatam is very dear to the devotees, as stated in the Bhagavatam itself, 12.13.18. Srimad Bhagavatam Puranam Amalam Yad Vaishnavanar Priyam. In this narration, there is nothing about material activities, economic development, sense gratification or liberation. Srimad Bhagavatam is the only narration in which the transcendental nature of the Supreme Lord and His devotees is fully described. Thus, the realized souls in Krishna consciousness take continual pleasure in hearing such transcendental literatures, just as a young boy and girl take pleasure in association. Om Agnana Dimirandhasya Agnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Sri Gurun Sri Yutapada Kamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavanscha Sri Rupam Chakrajatam Sahagana Raghunatanvitam Tam Sajivam साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांता राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधरा श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा टुडे वी हैव दिस मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट एंड very useful text for the devotees to understand, to follow, to preach, to discuss, to converse with each other. So the qualities of the pure devotees explained here, they don't waste even a single moment. Prabhupada has written 24 hours discussing about Krishna, talking about the glorification, listening to Krishna's glorification. Tushyanti cha ramanti cha. They feel so happy, satisfied. They feel the transcendental bliss. They feel very happy and they are satisfied also, both. How they are satisfied, how the devotees are satisfied? When they discuss among themselves, one will be talking, other person will be listening. Other person will be talking, then the others will be listening. There is nothing like superior or inferiority things here. So one will be discussing, talking about the glories of Krishna, all others will be listening and they enjoy. And the other person will glorify and talk about Krishna and all others will be listening. Oh, Krishna is such a great Krishna. What to talk about his form, his actions. Everything is full of pleasure. So, when the devotees are performing such activities, Krishna says, what I am going to do? He explains in the next sloka. These four slokas, 10.8 to 10.11, 10.8, 10.9, 10.10 and 10.11, they are called the Chatusloki Bhagavad Gita. The four most important slokas which whole Bhagavad Gita can be told in a few minutes. If somebody wants to know the gist of whole Bhagavad Gita, this is what actually it is. Number one, those who are intelligent, aham sarvasya prabhavo mattaha sarvam pravartate iti matva bhajante imam buddha bhava samanvita. Buddha means intelligent. Those who are intelligent, they will understand that everything is emanating from me, Krishna is saying. Everything is coming out from me. The moment they understand, what they do? They will engage themselves in the devotional activity. Everything you name, Krishna is saying, everything is emanating from me. Yesterday we have seen. And today, Krishna is saying, those who are intelligent, those who adopt the process of devotional life, how they actually behave, or how they should adopt their lives. Matchitta madgata prana. In their heart, always Krishna. There is no jealousy, there is no enviness or evil thoughts or any lust. It is only Krishna. When the heart is occupied with jealousy, where is the question of occupying with Krishna? It is Krishna is gone, forgotten. When heart is occupied with anger, where is the question of Krishna? It is gone. So Krishna is directly telling, if somebody wants to get my mercy, they do like this. If somebody wants to come back to my abode, they do like this. Matchitta madgata prana. Their lives are for Krishna. Their activities are for Krishna. They listen to Krishna's activities, pastimes. They talk about Krishna's pastimes and glories and feel extremely happy and satisfied. So for such devotees, what Krishna will do is explained in the next text, 10:10. Tesham evanu kampartam aham agnanajam tamaha nashayam yatma bhavastu gnanadipena bhasvata. This is. So, we will see in the two more days, very, very important slokas. And Tesham satata yuktanam bhajatam priti purvakam dadami buddhi yogam tam enamam upayantite. Tesham satata yukta. I will just explain so that you know the most important content of these four slokas. Tesham satata yuktanam bhajatam priti purvakam. Like this, those who are continuously, constantly praying and doing the devotional service, dadami buddhi yogam tam. I will give them, dadami, buddhi yogam, I will give the intelligence. What sort of intelligence? To make millions of rupees? To get a very big name and fame? No. Yena maam upayantite, so that he will come back to me, back to Bolo Kurunavan. I will give to those devotees who are constantly engaged in the devotional activities, the knowledge, so that he can come back to me. How I give? How Krishna gives? This question may arise. So Krishna is saying in the 10:11, Tesham evanu kampartham aham agnana jam tamaha nashayami atma bhavasto gnana deepena bhasvata. I now sit in his heart with gnana deepa, the torch of knowledge. And the moment torch of knowledge is there, the darkness of ignorance automatically goes away. I drive away the darkness of ignorance which is there in the heart by taking the charge. I myself will be. Actually, Krishna is already sitting. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishto matta smriti jnanam apohanancha. Krishna is saying, whether anybody wants, whether anybody don't want, whether anybody believes, whether anybody has faith or not, I am living in each and every living entity. Bacteria, virus, elephant, man, snake, ant, anything. Any living entity. Krishna says, I am sitting comfortably. Virajaman. And I am sitting there and I am giving the three things: intelligence, memory and forgetfulness. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishto matta smriti jnana apoha. These three things I am giving. So Krishna is already there. Then why Krishna is saying, I will now dwell in his heart and then drive away the darkness? That's what we are going to discuss day after tomorrow. So kindly have all your things for day after tomorrow, then it will be quite interesting. So here today we see that the devotees, how they behave. No prajalpa. Prajalpa is waste of talking and wasting their time unnecessarily. Anything other than Krishna is prajalpa. Prabhupada defines in Nectar of Instructions, prajalpa. Atyahara prayasasya prajalpo niyamagraha janasangasya lolyamcha shadbir bhakti vinashyati. These are the six things which are going to actually become a big obstruction in the path of devotional service. So, the devotees, the whole thing starts with prajalpa. Oh, this man, you know about this man. What about him? Where? I saw him there. Acha, where? 10 o'clock in the night, he was standing outside one house. Something was. Why he was standing? Now goes on. That is of no use. If it is connected to Krishna, okay. So Parikshit Maharaj, while asking questions, he says, if it is connected to Krishna, kindly explain me. The question which I am asking, if you think it is connected to Krishna, kindly explain me. That means, if it is not connected to Krishna, better you ignore my question and continue your talk. So, if we adopt this process of controlling ourselves and following this, these are the qualities of pure devotees. Mat chitta, mat gata, prana. Always remembering Krishna. Prabhupada has made it so simple so that anybody and everybody can understand. Always remembering and always doing the service, listening and also preaching and also glorifying. He talks about Krishna, and when somebody is telling about Krishna, he listens carefully. Yes, oh yeah, this is what actually Bhagavatam says. Yeah, you have quoted about Bhagavad Gita. Yes. So he appreciates. He is quoting. Oh, he is showing his scholarship, Pandita. Nice sloka he has quoted. He understands with a full heart filled with love for Krishna, devotional service. That is devotional service. Listening, talking about Krishna, doing anything for Krishna. That's why we have the most famous sloka, which is discussed in, which is told in every Bhagavatam by many speakers. Aradhyo Bhagavan Vrajeshatanayastadhama Vrindavanam Ramya Kachidupasana Vrajavadu Vargenaya Kalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pranamanam Amalam Prema Pumottomaham Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Matamidam Tatradaranapara. So, the whole gist of Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya is explained here in this one sloka by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur in the Chaitanya Matta Manjusha. Krishna is the topmost object of worship. This also covers what is known as Sambandha, Abhideya and Prayojana. Krishna is the most object of the worship, topmost object, and equally is the Vrindavan, which is equally worshipable. That is the first point. Second point, the process of worship is the process shown by gopis. Gopis, the way they have shown the process of worship. What gopis are doing actually? Whatever they do, it is for the pleasure of Krishna. Whatever activity they do, whether they become angry, it is to make Krishna happy. Krishna goes to them, why are you so angry? And he will talk. I will tell something. Krishna will say something. To make Krishna happy. If they wear very nice dress to make Krishna happy, to make Krishna, Krishna will feel happy when I am wearing like this. I take my pot with butter so that Krishna can take. He can break the pot or he can do anything. He can take it for Krishna. Anything. That's why Radharani is the topmost devotee, because 100% activities done by Radharani is for Krishna. Anything. Even if she inhales, it is for Krishna. If she exhales, it is for Krishna. If she puts on very nice garments, it is for Krishna. If she eats, it is for Krishna. If she becomes angry, it is for Krishna. If she shouts at Krishna, it is for Krishna's pleasure. So that sort of a worship which is shown by the gopis, that is the topmost worship. And the most authoritative divine relation is the Srimad Bhagavatam. And Krishna Prema is the fifth and ultimate goal of human life. That's what this sloka, Aradhyo Bhagavan, Prajetadanya explains. This is the Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya's whole philosophy in a nutshell. Number one, Krishna is the topmost worshipable Supreme Lord. There is no other person, there is no other God who is superior. He is the topmost. Number two, the way the gopis have worshipped, that is the topmost worship. Number three, the most authoritative relation or the divine relation is Srimad Bhagavatam, or the most authoritative proofs are given, contained in Srimad Bhagavatam. Then Krishna Prema is the goal of human life. So, taking the whole thing, Prabhupada explains the Bhakti Lata, which is explained in Chaitanya Charitamritam Madhya Leela, chapter 19. Chapter 19 of Chaitanya Charitamritam, we see how Srila Rupa Goswami came out of the clutches of that service in the Muslim king Nawab Hussain Shah. And anyhow, in brief, he comes out, and whatever comes out of the service of Nawab and whatever money he had, he gives 10,000 gold coins to one grocery shop fellow to keep it. Why? Because Sanatan, he was assuming there will be problems and this is for emergency purpose, 10,000 gold coins. And remaining whatever money he had, he fills it in two ships. You see how much rich he was, Rupa Goswami. He was minister along with Sanatan Goswami. He fills it in two ships and takes it to Banka Nagla. And there he distributes to his relations. He doesn't ignore the responsibility. He gives to his relations, gives to brahmanas, gives to friends, and keeps some amount for his emergency needs. And then he goes to Prayag and meets Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives him instructions to Rupa Goswami for 10 days continuously. In those 10 days, what he has described, in brief, it is given in chapter 19. And the Bhakti Lata Bija is explained there, starting from Bhakti Lata. Brahmanda Brahmite Kon Bhagyavan Jeeva Guru Krishna Krupa Paye Bhakti Lata Bija. Mahaprabhu explains Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami, listen. You are going to write so many books for the use of Vaishnavas and for following the Vaishnava philosophy, so you listen. Rupa Goswami, with great attention, he gets the mercy of Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu says the first thing, Brahmanda Brahmite Kona Bhagyavan Jiva. In this universe, 84 lakh of species are going up and down, going up to Brahmaloka also and coming back, or going to Patala and coming back to the earth. But while travelling, that is, some people, some thousands of souls, atmas are there in Swargaloka, thousands are there in other planets and doing their activities, whatever enjoyment or suffering or whatever it is. Though among these thousands and thousands and thousands of millions of these atma souls, who is the most fortunate person? Mahaprabhu explains, Kon Bhagyavan Jiva, Guru Krishna Kurpa Paye Bhakti Lata Bija. In his heart, who gets the seed of devotional service, seed of bhakti? He is the one who is the most fortunate. And when the bhakti seed has come into the heart, how one has to make it grow, make it fructify? It is only seed. It has to become a plant, and then it has to become a big plant and then go. So it is in the form of a seed now. So the steps are clearly given in Chaitanya Charitamrita from text number 152 to 163 of Chaitanya Charitamrita, chapter number 19. I will just tell the brief, because we have very short time. These seeds sprouts and gradually grows and penetrates beyond the Viraja river, provided it is watered by the process of Sravana and Kirtana, hearing and chanting. Only by hearing and chanting, this seed starts fructifying, that is, it becomes, it sprouts, it takes the small leaves and starts coming out. And then the seed grows and penetrates beyond the Viraja river. The more he continues with chanting and hearing, the more the Bhakti Lata grows. And it goes to Brahmaloka, and then Brahma Teja or Brahma Jyoti, and then reaches the Golok Vrindavanam. The person or the devotee or the gardener, as explained here, he is still on the earth only. He is performing the activities of chanting and hearing. This is equivalent to watering the seed, and the plant is growing. Growing, and it has reached Golok Vrindavan. Then, with more and more Sravana and Kirtana, it grows and attains the shelter of Krishna. When it attains the shelter of Krishna, the creeper starts producing the fruits of love. This devotional transcendental love is being produced, although this man is watering here and doing all that, but one should be extremely careful that as he is nourishing, watering, there are other plants which are growing, the weeds, unwanted latas, unwanted creepers are also growing, they will also grow. Like a person who is in the devotional service, if he is singing very nicely, bhajan, everyone is singing or not? Everyone is appreciating me or not? Now, one side, that is also that possibility is there, it may grow. That should be removed. Otherwise, Mahaprabhu explains, if it commits offenses and if the unwanted things grow, then the creeper's leaves start drying up. It becomes dry, it starts becoming sick and it doesn't grow. So, defense against these offenses, defending the tree is the most important. Then if it is continued with all the activities without committing any offenses and throwing away unnecessary plants, unnecessary creepers, he should be able to distinguish clearly the Bhakti Lata plant and the other plant. And simultaneously here the fruits are taking shape in Golok Vrindavan. And these fruits, they fall down. They ripe and fall down. Those fruits the devotee takes, enjoys, and then starts climbing with the tree and goes back to Golok Vrindavan. So this is the process which is explained in Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela from chapter 19, 152 to 163, which are relevant here for the seed, for the seed of devotional service and the Bhakti Lata. But if we don't observe the unnecessary weeds, we may fall down. Just like Saubari Muni. Saubari Muni was performing all austerities inside the water. You see, outside water, oh, so much of disturbance. Somebody may call, somebody may ask, some may show the direction, some people may come. If you are inside the water, nobody is seeing, and the sounds, no sounds. And he was practicing that. He has to gather under the water the austerities, tapasya. And one day, suddenly he sees two fish, they are playing and doing the sexual affairs. He sees, then he thinks, oh, these fish are enjoying. I should also enjoy. Why I am doing all this? I should also enjoy, I can. He goes out. He comes out from the water with a long beard. Years and years of austerity. His body is actually shaking. His head is trembling. Shaking continuously. And with that he goes to the king. Who is the king? Mandata. Mandata. Mandata king. He goes there and asks, O king, I have decided to marry one of your daughters. You have 50 daughters. Please give me one daughter I want to marry. Mandata looks, this fellow, head is shivering, hands are shivering, he is unable to stand properly, voice is not coming, all hair, such a long hair, totally white, gone. This fellow may, anytime he may leave the body, it looks like that. And this fellow comes and he wants to marry my daughter. But he knows, this fellow, he is a big Maharshi, he has got lot of powers, he cannot say no. So he says, my daughters, any daughter can choose anybody as her husband. So if any one of them is willing to marry you, I don't mind arranging the marriage. He says this and keeps sending. Immediately, Saubari Muni, who is very intelligent, immediately he understands his intention. If you go there, nobody will accept you, you will be rejected. Yes. My shape is like this. I have performed so many austerities. I have so much of power in me. So much of punya. The result of good activities is there. He uses them and becomes extremely handsome young man. And he goes, he was taken, Srimad Bhagavatam explains, he was taken into the palace of the princess, which was full of opulence. He looks at every opulence. And all the princes, all the 50 princes, they see. And see, oh, This man is suitable to me. You see, I am elder to you. I should get married first. No, he is suitable to me. No, I am younger to you. You see, you should accept your sister's words, your younger sister's words. He is. So all were quarreling among themselves. King comes here. Hey, what is this going on? We want to marry him. I want to marry him. I want to marry him. I want to marry him. All 50 daughters, they say, this man is surprised. Oh, this fellow had become like this. And everyone wants to marry. All of you want to marry? In one word, they say, yes. Now, he had already told, anybody who is willing to marry you, I will get you married. Now, everyone is willing to marry. So, he arranges the marriage and he gets married. With his high power he had, due to the austerities he has performed, he makes great palaces for each one of the wife. And each wife was staying in such an opulent house, enjoying all the opulences. One day, king comes and he wants to see how my daughters are staying. And he was wondered, one house, he goes, maybe this house is like that other house, equally opulent, highly opulent, and everyone is happy with so many children, 100 children, that's what they say, each one with his power. And he goes away. Now, Saubari Muni, every day he was thinking, yes, I have so much of, and his punya, his result of good deeds are slowly coming down, slowly had come down. And one day he was sitting under the shade of the tree he was looking at the river. Under this river, I was doing austerity. I didn't have any wife, I didn't have children, I didn't have any problems. Now 50 wives, 50 into 100, 5,000, I have made a big town itself, this one. Still, somehow, I am not happy. Oh my God, he shouts loudly. Look, the whole universe, look at me. I am the one who is fallen. I was performing austerities. I was trying to please Krishna, the Supreme. And I thought of pleasing myself one day by looking at those two fish. And he shouts, whole universe, learn from me. I am the person who is fallen here. Learn from my episode. Then he tells, my dear wives, thank you very much. I am going deep into the forest. All wives, they are extremely sincere, pious. They say, we want to follow you. They also follow him. They do all types of austerities and go back to Godhead. So after listening this, Parikshit Maharaj asks, please explain me, this man was doing such austerities under the water. He must have seen thousands of fish, thousands of times doing different activities, including sexual activity. Every day he was sitting under the water doing all the austerities. Why suddenly he saw something and suddenly it looks surprising. He was performing for years together under the water with thousands of fish around him. And one day he sees one pair of fish and he gets up and goes and gets married. This is something I am not understanding. Immediately, he was told, Parikshit Maharaj was explained about the episode where he offended Garuda. Garuda was catching fish and in the river, and this man, Saurabh Muni, objects for that. You see, you can't catch fish here. They are living peacefully. Garuda says, this is my food. I am taking my food. What is your problem? No, the peace is spoiled here. If you come here, you don't know, you are going to get cursed from me. Better don't come. Garuda, who carries Vishnu Bhagavan, who carried the whole Mandanagiri mountain for churning the milky ocean, which the asuras, demons and demigods together they were bringing, they were unable to bring it, they fell down. It was so heavy. And that Vishnu Bhagavan simply carries with left hand, keeps it on Garuda. And Garuda takes it. Such a powerful person. He is, after all, he is, every day he is in contact with Vishnu Bhagavan. He is the most great Vaishnava. And that Vaishnava was offended. That's why he fell down. But because he performed austerities earlier, he was again saved back. So here we see that, as Prabhupada has explained, Bhakti Lata Bija will get into problems. It doesn't fructify if we don't do chanting and hearing properly. And even if it is growing, it can have, any time it can get into problem and it may not give the fruit unless we are careful in our chanting and hearing and identifying the offenses which we are knowingly, unknowingly committing, and where we have to remove certain kalmasha, impurities from us, we have to inspect ourselves and remove it. Then only this machitta madgata prana bodhayanta parasparam kadayantascha mam nityam tushyanti cha ramanti cha can happen. Otherwise, then it is like from Delhi to Vrindavan, 120 kilometers board is there. Oh, 120 kilometers, I am on the path. Oh, I can reach any time. You can reach. You should start walking. Oh, it is 120 kilometers. Okay, I will go. I will enjoy here for some years, some time and go. 120 kilometers only. You have to do, you have to perform your activities, then you can go. Though we have taken the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we are sure to go back to Godhead, but how many lives, whether it is in this life only or after millions, millions, millions and millions and millions of lives, it is in the individual's hand. Having taken Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, the seed is there. It is there. It has to grow. It has to grow and reach Golok Vrindavan Dham and give the fruits, and that fruits we have to take it, and then the love of Godhead will be totally, fully awakened in the heart. So, this sloka gives us the clear cut picture of how a pure devotee should behave, how a pure devotee should do the activities. I thought I should speak this. I stop here. And if you have some comments, questions, you can ask me. We will discuss. Prabhu, have the mic, you can say. Ah, yeah.
You have the three stages of emotional services described. You have a stage, and then one other.
Yeah. Yeah, when the Bhakti Lata Bija is growing, yeah.
Which mature stage?
Yeah.
Other than the transcendental stage.
Yes.
Can you clarify what are the difference between
that? In the purport. Primary stage of devotional service, they release the transcendental pleasures from the service itself. And in the mature stage, they actually be situated in the love of Godhead. Now, actually, when we are doing any service, It gives us the pleasure, gives us, you will be very happy to do the service. You will be happy that you have done the service. I have performed the service. I is there initially. That is the preliminary stage. I have done. I could chant. How many chants? Now today I have chanted 16 rounds. I have chanted 32 rounds. I have done. But in the final stage, Prabhupada explains, it is totally in the love of God. How much I tried to please Krishna? Whether Krishna has been pleased by my activities, I may suffer. I may be having some stomach ache. I have performed. Whether Krishna has been pleased or not. He doesn't see whether my stomach ache is gone by performing the devotional service. In the initial stage, he feels, I have performed the devotional service, I am very happy. I think my stomach ache also will go now. Because I have performed the devotional service. That means he is performing the devotional service for himself. That is, in the final stage, that's what, in the mature stage, any activity, every activity is for Krishna. That's why the gopis' love is the topmost love in the sloka which I explained. Yeah. Are you clear? The in-between the stages are, so that is the initial, this is the final. In between, sometimes the eye will come, some unwanted plants are grown, you have to take them out. And the growth will be slow if chanting and hearing process is not proper. So, the Bhaktilata Bija will fructify and then become a seed, become a plant, and it travels up to Golok Vrindavan, after going to Golok Vrindavan, it goes up to Krishna and takes shelter at Krishna and grows further, gives the fruit, and those fruits actually fall down. That's what Chaitanya Charitamrita Mahaprabhu is saying, that fruits will come to the gardener, that is the devotee, and devotee tastes them. Then the love is awakened totally. Then he starts climbing with the help of the plant, this Bhaktilata, this creeper. And then he reaches the Goloka Vrindavanam. That is the whole process. The goal is reaching Krishna. The process is Krishna Bhakti and, please, your question.
This whole process like Bhakti Lata Bhija, what is the practically in Krishna, like what is this rules, how person understand that I wish my devotee before I reach to Golok Vrindavan, you know, what is the rule comes from?
Very nice, very, very interesting question which you have asked. So, how a person knows whether he is progressing in the Krishna consciousness or not? This is in brief, that's what you want to ask. Yes, yes, that is the progress of the bhakti, progress of devotional service. Whether a person is progressing in devotional activity or not, this is seen by checking oneself. Number one, it is like I am practicing, I am in the class for 20 years, I am senior to you. You are in the class for 20 years, you are sitting in the class 1 for 20 years. And the person who is in the 10th class, you say I am senior to you because I am sitting in class 1 for 20 years. So it doesn't become, he doesn't become senior just by sitting in the class. His progress is by moving further. Whether I have come out of jealousy, whether I have come out of anger, whether I have come out of the lust, whether I have come out of the greed, when we check up ourselves, we ourselves will know. Whether my activities are for Krishna, whether my activities are only for Krishna. When the activities are only for Krishna, that is what Gopi Bhava, that is what the devotional service which are rendered by gopis, we are trying to attain. So we have to check up ourselves whether our activities are only for us, only for Krishna, or in between. Sometimes for Krishna, sometimes for myself. Yeah. If we check, we ourselves, honestly, we come to know. And when we are doing the devotional service, Krishna says, I take the charge. Tomorrow, day after tomorrow, we see the two more slokas, Krishna removes the remaining part. But we have to sincerely adopt the previous one, that is today's, Matchitta Madgata Prana, always remembering Krishna, never forgetting Krishna, all activities, remembering, talking, no prajalpa, anything related to Krishna and everything related to Krishna only. Other than that, nothing else. These are the impurities, yeah. Bhakti-rasa will not grow, it won't even reach.
Things are removed.
Yeah.
Let us say somebody is out of this thing.
Yes.
So where is Bhakti-rasa?
It will go up to Krishna's lotus feet and take the shelter.
Yes,
yeah.
Let us say devotional practitioner
Sadhaka. Yeah.
He realizes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now where is
Bhakti-rasa? That depends on the stage where you are. How much jealousy had gone. Whether 10% jealousy has gone or 90% has gone, 99% has gone. So your guru is the best person, your Guru Maharaj or the guru to whom an individual has taken the shelter. When you ask Guru Maharaj, can you kindly explain me where I am? Guru Maharaj will look at you and tell you in seconds. He is the most appropriate person who knows. So, I mean, we have to check up ourselves whether my activities are for Krishna or for myself. Yeah, that's what you have to. Just many times we have discussed in the class. Again, I give the same example. If a person is making a parotta, his son had come from Delhi, mummy, make me parotta. You make such nice aloo parotta, your parottas are the best. Today I wanted to make puri, but you are asking, you want me to make parotta. Okay, make parotta. Mummy, give. No. It has to be offered. Offer it to Krishna and give it. For whose purpose you have made parottas? For your son. Frankly, very honestly. You wanted to make parotas for only son, and in the process Krishna is coming. You have to offer. Without offering, don't touch. Nice. But the same thing when the totally Krishna conscious person, oh Krishna, today I thought of making puri for you. Today you want to eat parotta. And you asked my son to come all the way from Delhi to remind me that I should make parotta for you. Oh Krishna, you are so glorious. I make parotta for you. Kindly taste it. Oh, nicely. Don't disturb. Oh, my grandson, don't disturb. This is made for Krishna. Oh Krishna, kindly take it. You didn't tell me directly, you want to tell through my son. Still, you are so kind, you have told me. Please take it. And then you eat. Same thing is done. Same thing for one. There is mix it. Some kalmasha is there when it is done for me, for my son, for when it is done exclusively for Krishna. That's what actually is. When the activities are exclusively for Krishna, everything is for Krishna. That is the gopi bhava. If there is something mixed it, we are adding the kalmasha. We are adding impurities. We have impurities. Honestly, we have to try to take out. Tell Krishna, tell Radharani, Radhe, please give me strength. Make such circumstances that these impurities are removed. Anything, let anything happen to me, I don't bother, but these impurities should be removed from me. Kindly Krishna, show mercy on me. Create circumstances so that these impurities are removed. I don't bother. Whether anybody beats me, slaps me, or insults me, or elevates me very high, definitely Krishna will take care. Thank you very much. Any other questions, Prabhu? Oh.
Regarding this checking of this at the bottom, what is the devotional service activity? So, he can check himself from the divine qualities developed as per the
100%. 100%. When we check ourselves, whether the divine qualities which are to get imbibed in the devotee, it should come. Whether I am simple, whether I am honest, whether I am everything. Any other question, Prabhuji? Are yours?
This Bhakti Lata Beach,
yeah.
When it is growing and then as if by Vaishnava Prabhu Bhakti Lata.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, Prabhu. Please.
So, now the if it is uprooted from the very root, that is annihilated. So now how it will again be?
Brahmanda Brahmite, Kon Bhagyavan Jeeva. Again you have to wait for the pure devotees association and get the seed of bhakti again, if it is uprooted and gone.
So, say in our devotee association, now someone has committed Vaishnava Prat, we see some devotees go away and like that. But then he is still coming to Vaishnava association, but he does not have taste. He does not have taste. I am just trying to express, I hope you can understand. So, now what is happening with the Bhakti Lata Beach actually?
Here it is explained, if the chanting or hearing process are not proper, it gets dried. It gets dried, and if offenses are so much, the further slokas in Chaitanya Charitamrita say, the Hathi Matav, as you explained. So it uproots the whole plant. When it is uprooted, then you have to get the seed again. So seed again and process should start. But the thing is, it won't get uprooted, it don't get uprooted to that extent that it starts from zero. Whatever service had been done, 5% is done, the moment seed has come, it grows very fast, 5%, already there. And it starts from 5%, 10%, 50%, 90%, whatever it is. Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela, chapter 19. Nineteen, 151 to 163. Chaitanya Charitamrita, chapter 19, 151 to 162 or 163. It continues. It will be very useful. This what Mahaprabhu has explained. Directly, we all should read again and again. Any other questions? Thank you very much for very active participation and asking so many questions. Mataji, any other questions? Any question? So, if you don't have any questions here, I stop here. Srimad Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.